to my chief apostle, Chief Apostle Dr. William Richard Harrell Jr. Clap your hands for my leader. Hallelujah. We thank God for my chief apostle, to my mom, my first lady in her absence, First Lady Joanne Harrell. We thank God for her in her absence. To our elder elect, Jamal Caldwell, to the pastor of this house. To the pastor of this house, your pastor. Clap your hands for the woman of God. Hallelujah. To the pastor that is allowing us this space, our Pastor Mobley, we thank God for him. We thank God for him. We're going into the Word. We're going into the Word. But I just feel God right about now. And there's a song that's on my spirit, if I may. Ain't no need to worry him. What the night's gonna bring. It will be all over in the morning. If you know what, help me say. Ain't no need to worry him. What the night's gonna bring. It will be all over in the morning. In the on my spirit, because there's many things that we are going through on a day-to-day basis. There are many things that we are going through on a day-to-day basis, and we feel like it's going to last forever. We feel like things will not get better, but I come to let somebody know that for weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. I come to encourage someone on tonight that your weeping is a possibility. Yeah, there's a possibility that you're going to weep in the nighttime. There's a possibility that you are going to cry sometimes. But joy coming. Joy is absolute. Joy is on its way. Can I get enough God believers to lift their hands and say, Lord, I thank you for my joy is coming. It will be all over in the morning. Ezekiel,
yes, sir.
The 37th chapter,
yes, sir.
37th chapter of Ezekiel. Starting at the first verse, when you have it, say, I have the word. If it's in your heart, just say, I have it. The 37th chapter, starting at the first verse, declares that hand of the Lord was in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley. Someone say the valley. Which was full of bones. I feel like preaching already. And caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there was very many in the open valley, and lo, they were dry. Someone say dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these dry bones live? And I'm gonna make this all make sense in a minute. But can these dry bones live? And I answered, someone say, answer him. O Lord God, thou knowest. Verse 4 declares, and he said unto me, prophesy unto these bones and say unto them, pausing right there, prophesy unto these bones. God, you mean these dry bones that just laying there ain't doing nothing, ain't moving. You want me to speak to these things? And we find it hard because we go through dry situations. There's some dry situations that we go through on a day-to-day basis, and only God is not telling you to just go through, but God is telling you to speak to your situation. Moving swiftly, prophesy unto these bones and say unto them, oh, ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Yes. Pausing there, in this scripture you find it saying, oh, ye dry bones, hear ye the word of the Lord. It's not asking, I found it funny, it's not asking to listen, but you're commanding your situation to hear what God has told them. Verse 5, thus says the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live. Verse 6 says, and I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you and cover you with skin and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. I'm going down to the 10th verse, just bear with me. Verse 7 says, so I prophesied as I was commanded. Someone say, follow God's voice. And I, as I prophesied it, there was a noise. Someone say, there's a sound. And behold, a shaking, and the bones came together, bone to his bone. God, I feel you right now. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came upon them, and the skin covered them above, but there was no breath in them. I thought God said he was gonna do it. We moving though. Verse 9 says, then said he unto me, prophesy unto the world, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, thus saith the Lord. God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain that they may live. Concluding at the 10th verse, declare, so I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army. Touch your neighbor and say, can these dry bones live?
Can these dry bones live?
Can these dry bones live? People of God, the ones that are listening, we have all been in situations where we feel like things aren't gonna get better. I wanna paint a picture for you. I understand people have came out today with a smile on their face.
Amen.
But not everybody knows what's behind the smile.
Amen.
I'm reminded of a commercial. I'm not sure what it is, but it's a depression commercial, and people walk around with a plate in front of their face with a smiling face. But on behind that face, they are upset, they're frowning, they're depressed. There's something going on. And I understood this in church, people. We don't speak about what we go through all the time. We go through so many things and we take up so much. And I know it's tough, but God said, told me to tell you, speak to your situation and tell it to live.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
Let's look at the background of this scripture. God has called his people, the Jews, out of captivity.
Yes, sir.
In Egypt for 100 years, they had been in Egyptian captivity. In this text, we find God brought them into the promised land and gave them a land and a king and made them a nation.
Yes, sir.
But they turned against God. How many of us have been in a place where we found, like, God, I don't think this is for me. I think I'd be better off in the world. I think I'd be better off at the parties and hanging out with whoever I want to hang out with. But we have all been in a place where we felt like it was time to give up on God. But what I understood is we should never come in our mind that we should give up on God. Why? Because God has never gave up on us. And if God never gave up on us, which means that he was always there even when you thought he had left you. I'm moving. So the Nebuchadnezzar and his Babylonian army invaded a city called Israel. They had reduced Solomon's temple to ashes.
Yeah.
I just want to give you a background of this text and how and had taken many of the Jewish people back to Babylon as captives. They took them back to Babylon as hostages, took them back as prisoners.
Yes, sir.
This is the condition that Ezekiel is in. The nation of Israel is dead. The nation of Israel is dead, but God has a vision for Ezekiel. Someone say, follow God's vision.
Follow God's vision.
Ezekiel is carried to a valley full of dry bones.
Come on.
This is where we're going into the text now.
Yes, sir.
He is carried into a valley of dry bones. I want you to imagine this scene with me. These bones are scattered everywhere, very white and very dry. If you've seen a chicken bone, you would see the color, the texture of the bone. You would see how it feels moist because of the fact that it has came out of somewhere where there was a liquid. But in this case, it's not the case, because usually when you see a bone that's white and crusty, usually it is dry. And you don't really, it's not much you can do with a dry bone. I'm gonna make it make sense. There's not much you can do with the dry bone from the natural aspect. You cannot do things with a dry bone. You can give them to your dog and he can chew on that for a little while. But there's nothing you can really do with a dry bone. But God had a plan.
Yes.
These very white dry bones were scattered all over the place.
Yeah. Come on,
Apostle, you're gonna help me preach today. They were scattered by the wild animals, so that there is nothing but bones as far as the eye can see.
Yes.
We can see some things, but God sees further. Elder Elect Caldwell, in this text we find that Ezekiel is, this is a vision of the nation of Israel. There was no way that Israel could get themselves